Cosplay can be bought, can be made, it can be thrifted from stores, it can be as accurate as you want it to be, it can be as little as you want it to be. Basically what it is, it's Halloween all year round. Hi, my name's Lisa, also known as Cheshliddle, and I am a cosplayer from New Zealand. I am completely self-taught in making costumes, and I'm just a big nerd that likes to dress up.
So this is my little crafting space. I'm very lucky to have one, but this is where I make most of my stuff. Most of the time it can spread out to the rest of the house.
On the left we have Daenerys Targaryen from Game of Thrones. I made her 7th season outfit for him when she first met Jon Snow. All of this red and gold you see here, that's all hand embroidered. I made these chains by using Warbler's deco art, which is like polymorph pellets. Molded all of those and did individual chain links. The dragons, which unfortunately got broken, the dragons were casted out of resin. This fabric I had brought over from the States. There's nothing more satisfactory in being able to put on a costume, especially one that you've made, and walking out onto the con floor and somebody recognizing you and being like, hey, you're cosplaying as such and such. You can just feel like a badass, and you don't have to be you. You can take on the persona of whoever you're cosplaying. Like, for example, when I've cosplayed Daenerys, she's a strong ass boss bitch. And so like, I've taken some of that, like when cosplaying, I'm like, yeah, I'm a boss ass bitch. I guess getting inspiration for what I want to cosplay, emotional attachments. Like if it's a character that I've had a connection to while watching, like whether anime or whether it be Game of Thrones or whatever, or the costume just looks badass, I'm like, I hate myself, I want to make that thing. So Warbler is a thermoplastic material where when you heat it up, it goes sticky and floppy. Then as it cools, it hardens and then helps us create the shape. Shiny side up. Still short of one. Then you can paint, put detailing, put whatever extra bits you want on it. Quickly made a couple of bubbles because I made it super, super quick. So you have crossplay and then you have gender bent. Crossplay is, for example, as if I was to change my physique to be a male. I would, you know, for example, bind my chest, place facial hair, contour. Whereas gender bending is taking a female character and making it male. For example, being a male Harley Quinn, a female Joker. Crossplaying and gender bending, especially crossplay in the, especially in our Kiwi community, we're very open to it. Openness and people's gender fluidity, like being gender fluid or being transgender. And I think a couple of people that I know have been able to use cosplay to actually explore that identity and that side of themselves and become a lot more comfortable with who they are because our New Zealand community has actually been so accommodating with it. I could go on for years on what the best way to start cosplay is. Pick a character you like, figure out how you're gonna make it, figure out where you're gonna wear it, and do it. I cannot stress enough how many times I have messed up by not making a mock-up. Make a mock-up. Practice, practice, practice. Do it because it's fun and do it because you enjoy it.